Hello guys, in this video we learn how to grab objects with the player. First, let's take a look at the boxes that we can grab. They need to have one collider and a rigid body 2D component. Also, it's a good idea to create a special layer just for objects you can grab. My layer is called Objects. Next, let's select the player. The player needs to have two transform child objects. One is ray position, from which we shoot a ray to detect collisions, and another is called grab position, in which we place grabbed objects. The player has the grab objects script. Let's open it. As you can see, we have transform grab point and ray point variables, float ray distance, and also we have one game object variable that we use as a holder for the grabbed object. By default, it's null. We also need one integer layer index. So in the start function, we will store the layer objects as an integer for better performance. In the update function, first we use ray casting to create a ray from the ray point position. The direction is to the right, and we use ray distance to determine the length of the ray. Information about the ray and what object it hits we store in the hitInfo variable. Now let's check conditions. If we hit something, that means the hitInfo collider is not null, and also the object we hit needs to have the correct layer index. Then we check inputs. As you can see, I use the new input system. For that, you need to import the input system package and in the script include the input system namespace. So, if we press the space key and grabbed object is null, that means that we didn't grab an object before, then we can grab the current one. First, store the object into the grabbed object variable. Then we can change the rigid body settings of the grabbed object from dynamic to kinematic. Next, we move the grabbed object to the grab point position. The last thing is to set the player as a parent object with the setParent function. The else if condition is to release the grabbed object. We also use the space key. Notice that we don't have the null condition, which means that we already grabbed the object. First, set rigidBody2D kinematic to false. Set parent to null and clear the grabbed object variable. The last thing, you can use debug.drawRay to see the ray in the scene window when playing. In Unity, don't forget to assign transform points and ray length. Press the play button, go to the box, press the space key to grab the box. You can move with it and press the space key to release the box. Nice, that's all for today. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and turn on notifications. See you in the next video.